As we go through this course, remember, as we speak and sleep, very little stays in the same place. Not only our weather, but you too. Now, all these numbers will be approximate, but at our equator, the speed of rotation is approximately 1,040 miles per hour. The Earth is moving around the Sun at about 67,000 miles per hour. Our solar system is moving toward the constellation of Hercules at 45,000 miles per hour. And our planet and all bodies are rotating around the center of our Milky Way galaxy at approximately 492,125 miles per hour. So nothing really stays the same. It's always moving. Fortunately, our weather doesn't move at that speed, although at times it seems like it. Weather as we know it would not exist on the planet Earth without the ever-changing position of the Earth relative to the Sun as we make transit around the Sun. Now look at this graphic. On the right-hand side, winter time, northern hemisphere. We're kind of pointed away from the Sun, and it gets cold, right, in the winter. We're actually closer to the Sun in the winter than we are the summer. But since we point away, we get less heating. Kind of wild. So you're closer in the winter than you are in the summer. Combine all of this with the tilt of the Earth on its axis and the 24-hour rotation on its axis, and then we have our seasons and we have the days that become longer or shorter, except for a few times during the year. And you know, you see the axis of the Earth there? There's some research that shows a wobble on the axis occurs every several hundred thousand years, and that wobble has led to significant climate change. Let us hope it doesn't wobble soon. Now, the energy from the Sun, it's called solar radiation. It provides the energy that heats the Earth, and then the Earth heats the atmosphere. A lot of people think that the Sun heats the air. No, the Earth heats the atmosphere. Now, the movement of our Earth and the topography of Earth causes heating of the atmosphere that is not balanced, it's not equal, being hotter in one area and colder in others. This is called differential heating. Usually the warmer air will have lower atmospheric pressure. It weighs less. And the colder region has higher pressure, means the air is heavier there. The differential heating that causes a difference in pressure between two locations results in what is called the pressure gradient force. So you got the high pressure over there, and you got the lower pressure over there, and so there's a pressure difference, a pressure gradient. And that pressure gradient causes the wind to flow toward the lower pressure. The bigger the gradient, the more change in the pressure, the stronger the wind. You experience it in Oklahoma many times. If we've had a cold front and the winds come around suddenly, storm system comes in the west, and then the winds increase from the south because of a tight pressure gradient. Now, in order for a thunderstorm to form, air must go up. Somehow you have to get it to go up. And once the center part of that goes up, we call that an updraft. Now that vertical wind, the updraft may exceed 100 miles per hour in some cases. You know, keep that in mind. Let's take a look at this graphic here. Let's just say it says P1, that's sea level, that's the ground. Let's say the pressure there is 10, arbitrary number 10. You go up to 18,000 feet and it would be a 5. So in the first 18,000 feet of the atmosphere, you lose half of your atmosphere. You don't lose it, but it's there, but the pressure decreases by half. You would think there would be one incredible vertical pressure gradient, but the large vertical pressure gradient alone is not sufficient to create a thunderstorm.